Welcome back, Zombabes and Zombros. It's your main man with the mask, Saint357, bringing you yet another Saint Reviews. This time around, I'm reviewing the new straight-to-DVD zombie movie, Maggie. To give you an idea what it's all about, the synopsis reads like this. A teenage girl in the Midwest becomes infected by an outbreak of a disease that slowly turns the infected into cannibalistic zombies. During her transformation, her loving father stays by her side. Now, I tend to generally avoid some of the more unknown zombie movies. I mean, for fuck's sake, there are some really lousy ones out there that'll just make you wish a zombie would claw your eyes out. But this one had some fairly positive reviews online, but what really drew me in was the male lead. Now, he's an actor from the 80s and early 90s, mostly known for his action roles. He hasn't really been seen in any movies for a while till his return not too long ago. But you'll most likely remember him as the former governor of California. That's right, it's Schwarzenegger himself. Now, if you grew up watching his movies like I did, then this must have been a dream come true. I mean, Arnold in a frickin' zombie movie? Come on, that's like my ultimate fanfic right there. But there's bad news, my little ghouls. This is not the zombie brain-exploding action-packed 28 Days Later meets Predator mashup that we've been hoping for. Instead, it's a touching family drama that just so happens to have zombies in it. So while you may see Arnold kill a Zed here and there, I'm afraid it's not with a machete and machine gun arm while smoking a cigar and cracking off one-liners. So amid all the gunfire, explosions, and catchphrases following Arnold's return to the big screen, Schwarzenegger also managed to find time for some genuine acting. Set against the backdrop of a small Midwestern town in the aftermath of a deadly pandemic that produces zombie-like symptoms, Maggie opens with a quiet family man, Wade Schwarzenegger, driving into the city to pick up his daughter, who has just been diagnosed with the virus. Unlike The Walking Dead, whose characters would resolve this problem with a well-placed shot from a crossbow or pistol, the world of Maggie is much more humane. There are numerous protocols in place for keeping the virus contained, including setting aside a quarantine zone where the affected are sent to live among each other until their condition deteriorates to a point where they must be euthanized. Still in the early stages of the infection, Maggie is allowed to return home with Wade, where the admonishment that she be taken to the quarantine zone once her symptoms become worse. Maggie's stepmother, Jolie Richardson, sends her own child to stay with relatives as a precautionary measure, and the ramshackle farmhouse becomes a cradle of tension and sorrow as the family buys their time waiting for the inevitable. If you strip out the zombie-related elements, this could just as easily have been any number of films about a teenager with a terminal illness. The only real difference here is that Maggie's affliction leaves her prone to gray skin, wounds that won't heal, and a desire to consume raw flesh. Downplaying the horror in favor of focusing on the family drama is a superb choice and lends the film a distinct voice in the cacophony of already crowded genre. Maggie is easily the most emotional and melodramatic work of Schwarzenegger's career, a somber and melancholy affair that showcases a rage we've never seen from the aging action superstar. His on-screen relationship with Breslin, the daughter, feels authentic and believable, and it's hard not to sympathize with the loving father who knows his child is slipping away. As a directorial debut, Henry Hobson knows just when to pull up the audience's heartstrings. There's very little in the way of conventional horror, which might disappoint some of the genre fans, hoping for a few scares, like me. But this shouldn't be seen as a shortcoming. Maggie is an interesting and unique approach to a subject that is often glossed over in other zombie-related stories. And the quieter moments are the ones that resonate the most. So, in short, if you want to see a tender, touching story with zombies, who won, and some truly good acting from the last action hero, then check out Maggie. 1.5 rotten thumbs up. Now, I've been your guide through a world of death and sorrow, and as always, my children, go out and enjoy the waste.